Hi, my name is Thomas Kim. In this session, we will learn non-reentrant lexer and parser and reentrant lexer and parser. Non-reentrant lexer and parser uses global variables. In case of lexer, uses global variables to maintain state. Lexer uses global variables. In case of a parser, uses global variables yy, lbar to get semantic value from lexer. Lexer returns token and also returns llrbar using global variables defined in parser. In case of reentrant parser and lexer, lexer and parser communicates passing parameters. Lexer and parser communicates passing parameters. And lexer uses a parameter passed by parser to maintain state. This lexer uses yy scan t yy scanner variable as argument. Parser passes yy scan t yy scanner to lexer as argument. Also passes yy l value as a function argument to lexer to get semantic value. So reentrant parser uses parameters, function parameters, to maintain state and to get a semantic token. In case of non-reentrant parser, lexer maintains a state using global variables. Also parser's semantic value, yyl value, it is also global in non-reentrant parser. Using global variables means it is non-reentrant, not thread safe. Reentrant means thread safe. If we are going to develop software, we have to use reentrant parser, reentrant functions. So not thread safe means we cannot call or run multiple instances of the generated parser simultaneously. In a single process. Non-reentrant parser, we cannot call or run multiple instances of the generated parser simultaneously in a single process. Reentrant parser, we can call or run the generated parser multiple instances of the generated parser passers simultaneously. Simultaneous or at the same time, in a single process. So if we are going to develop software, we have to use reentrant, lexer, and parser. It is relatively simple. I said relatively. It is comparatively or relatively more complex. Reentrant parser is more complex. However, once we understand the logic behind reentrant parser, it is not difficult. It is not complex. I will detail reentrant parser in this video. As we know, Plex gets input Lexer L. It is called Plex input pile and Python gets parser Y. This pile is called the Python input pile. Plex generates Lexer CPP and Python generates parser CPP. In case of Plex, Lexer CPP, Lexer CPP implements YY Lex. In case of a non-reentrant parser, it generates INT YY pass like this. And non-reentrant parser, it calls non-reentrant Lexer like YY character YY Lex. In YY pass calls YY Lex like this without any argument in non-reentrant parser. To make it reentrant parser, we specify in this pile percent option, reentrant. If we specify this option, if we give this option in this pile, then Plex generates INT YY Lex YY scan underscore T YY scanner. With this option, if we specify here, then this is reentrant scanner, lexical scanner. In case of Python, we give percent define percent define API pure pull API pure pull. If we give this option, then if we define this option in YY path, then Python still generates Bison still generates INT, YY, pass, the same as before. However, it calls, YY pass calls like this. YY character YY Lex pointer YY Alpha. In YY pass calls YY Lex like this. With this option. So there is a mismatch. First, it does not accept YYL bar. Second, it accepts YY scanner. To make it lexical scanner to accept YYL bar, we need to give option Python if we give option to this part YY Lexer, then it becomes INT YY Lex YY L bar YY L bar YY scanner. It becomes like this. It generates, if we give these two options, then flux generates INT, YY Lex, YY L bar, YY scanner. So in this case, in case of Bison, to put this parameter here, when it calls this parameter here, we have to give option like this, percent, we need a new option, percent, PARAM, parameter, PARAM, curly brace, what is this? YY YY scan T underscore T YY scanner. If we specify this option, this option to this part, then Bison parser generates INT YY pass YY scan T YY scanner. It generates YY pass like this and calls this YY Lex like this. YY L bar. Then YY scanner. So if you look this line of code with this one, it matches. YY L bar, YY L bar, YY scanner, YY scanner. So matches. In summary, if we want to create reentrant scanner and parser working together, we have to specify at least two options like this. And in Bison, we have to define two options. like this. But we also need to have locations, location tracking, location tracking. To use location tracking feature, we have to define percent location, locations. We have to give this option in this part. Then, if we give this option, then it calls YY pass calls YY character YY lex YY L bar YY LLOC then YY scanner pass YY pass calls YY lex like this way, three arguments. To make it consistent, we give option Python locations. If we give Python locations, then flux generates int yy lex percent yy l bar yy LLOC scanner YY scanner YY scanner. It generates functions like this. So matches. Now if we delete it, I will summarize them in one location. Percent option Python Breezy percent option Python locations. Here, parameter yy scan t yy scanner percent locations. So we have to specify three options to this part, yy parser y. And also we have to specify three options to this part. We want to create our custom class and want to send it to Plex, YYLex, and also want to send it to YYPass. Pass, we create, for example, C, pass, tree, and we will make an instance, for example, pass tree. If we make a class like this, custom class, we make ourselves, and an instance pass tree, for example, we want to pass it to YYLex and also YYPass. We want to use pass tree to both here, YYLex and YYPass. If we want to do that, We can do like this. In case of YY legs, we say another option. Option extra, extra type. Quote C plus 3 and star pointer like this. If we give option like this, then we will pass this instance in our code to before we call yypass, we will initialize yy scanner, yy scanner object. We create yy scanner object and initialize, then we call yy pass. Then in yy legs, we can access this variable, this instance, using yy extra. Yy extra. This is pointer. We can access this parse tree with this option. So in this case, in case of Bison, we send this instance to yypass as parameter. In this case, percent pass param c parse tree pointer yy extra. If we specify this option to parser.y, then Bison generates int yy pass. Because parameter, it comes first, then this one, it creates yy scanner, then this one, yy extra. Like this. It creates header file like this. More specifically, it can be int yy pass here. This one comes first. Yy scan t yy scanner. Then this c pass 3 pointer yy extra. It creates header file like this. This is c pass 3 and this is yy extra. With this command, with this option, Bison generates prototype like this. And then we can access this variable in parser grammar file. Then we can access yy extra as pointer. Yy extra actually points to this variable, yy pass, our custom object, custom class object. It also access this custom variable. We create a C parse tree and an instance parse tree. We create class C parse tree and a function int run pass. I would say run passer. It gets const string pylen. It gets a pylen argument. Then I'm creating this member function, run parser. First, yy scan t, yy scan t, scanner. Yy scan t is actually void. Yy scan t is like type def void pointer yy scan t. Yy scan t is actually void pointer. First, there we make yy scanner, and second, we make a file pointer in, and we open a file open. File open, then we give file name. I will use like this, file point in. Then file open as in, this is in, then file name length, file name. We convert it to C string, C str, C string, pylen, then read. This is third step. Then fourth step, we have to initialize. Yy lex init, this is function extra, yy lex init extra, and we have to pass this instance, C parse instance. Since we are in C parse class, this is member function, we pass, instead of this, we pass this. This means this instance. This. Then, ampersand scanner. We are initializing this. This post step. Yy lex init extra, initialize extra argument to yy scanner data structure. Fifth step, yy lex in yy lex in we put this instance here in scanner. Now we initialize fully like this. Then we call test 6. We call int rlt. Rlt means result. We call yy pass. Yy pass's first element, first argument is yyscanT. YyscanT. So it's a scanner. Scanner. And second element is parse tree. So this parse tree is the same this one. This is parse tree. Parse tree. So we are sending parse tree, the same element, the same instance of C parse tree. So it should be this. So we are calling parse tree like this. After calling, it continues. After calling, after this parse tree is executed, we have to destroy. Destroy. Then we have to close. We destroy scanner. We used this. Then we close this pile. We close this pile. Then we return. Then we return int. We return pass result, this value. Then we close this function. We close this function, then we close the class. End of C parse tree. This is end of this function, run parser. So we created a class C parse tree. Of course, it should be public. This function should be public, and we define run function like it gets file name. The first step is declare scanner data type, then file name declare. We open file and specify here in file name read, then yylex init extra. We initialize this instance, this, and yyscanner. Then we initialize the pile input file. Then we run pass. We have to pass this scanner here. And this is actually this instance. The same instance. This is passing to parser. This is passing to lexer. Lexer. Passing. Then we call yy pass. Then destroy yy scanner. Then close pile. This pile. Then returns. This function returns. This is basic mechanism. Then how we create the main function? We in main function, in function main, function main, int main, in function main, we create C plus 3, for example, plus 3, we create an instance, then we call parse 3 dot run parses. Then we consent the file name. We call file name, this is source code. Scripting language. This is the scripting language we are developing. Then int rlt, then we can get return value of this parse 3. Because this function, this member function calls this, this calls YY pass. So the application implemented this way. This is basic, most fundamental structure of reentrant parser. Before we wrap up this session, I need to mention one more thing. Python gets YY parser Y Python info file and generates parser CPP, and parser CPP implements YY pass and YY error. These are non-entrant Python parser, syntax parser, syntax analyzer. If we make it re-entrant, we have to define API dot pure then full. We have to give this option. It still does not change. These two function prototype does not change. But we need to pass parameter yy scan t scanner. We need to define one more options to pass scanner state. Then it changes. Both these two functions changes. This becomes int yy pass yy scan t, it becomes void yy error yy scan t yy scan t and constant character star. With this option, function prototype changes like this. We give another option for location tracking. We give another option, locations. We define this. So this file, then this function changes. If we give this option, it still remains the same, but it changes. INT, YY, pass is the same as before, but it changes. Void, YY, error, YY is empty. Then it becomes YY L type. Stop. YY L type means YY LLOC, YY LLOC address. Okay. YY L type. Stop. Then constant character. Const character pointer. With this option, it changes like this. Finally, we give another option, pass, P-A-R-A-M, C, pass tree, star, YY, extra, we give another option, then both changes. After this, YY pass becomes INT, YY pass. It comes first, YY scan T comes first. Then it comes. Here currently this is single one, but it is like this. It becomes C3, C pass 3. It becomes YY. I will name it pulling. It becomes YY. Scan T index scanner and C pass tree YY extra. YY extra. It becomes header file because function prototype becomes like changed like this. And this also changes, void, yy, error, also changes. It becomes yyllloc, it becomes yy, YY L type TYPE. YY LLOC. And the next is scan T. YY scan T. It becomes YY scanner. I will say YY scanner. YY a scanner. Scanner. I will say YY LLOC. Scanner. Then YY extra. Then constant character. It changes like this. 1, 2, 3, 4 elements. 4 arguments. Please note that This order can be changed. These two order can be swapped. If we change this one, this option, and this option, it is percent. This option and this option, this option defines this. This option defines this. If it comes first, it comes first. If it comes later, it comes later. If we swap it, this order can change. If we define first, YY scanner comes first. If it comes later, it comes later. First, later. Because it comes first, it comes late. It comes first, it comes late. If we swap it, if we define this first and it later, then this order gets changed. Also, if we define it, we define the location here, if we define a location some other place, this order can also change. But this always remains last. Then how can you check this order? How can you know this? How can you know YY error function prototype? That's easy. We just can look the code. Generate the code. Okay, this concludes our reentrant parser. If you understand this in this session of class, creating reentrant parser is not that very difficult. It might be quite challenging for you to remember all these things, but try to watch this video several times. And I also already filmed about how to create reentrant parser in real code using Visual Studio. I filmed video how to use Visual Studio, Visual C++ to implement reentrant parser in video. I already filmed. So I will put the link here. After watching this several times, watching this video, please watch another video that I filmed already. Also, if you watch the film, my previous video about reentrant parser, if you cannot understand, then watch this video. Also, about these two things, these two options, PALAM and PALAM, also LEX, PALAM. About these three options, I already filmed video about these three things. I also put the links of this video in comment section. Please, if you cannot understand these, please watch that video. If you like my video, this video, please subscribe and give me like button. Thank you for watching.